Hello and welcome to Tech. I'm Muhammad Adnan, and in this video, we are going to discuss about the next 5 Huawei interview question and answers. It's a part 14 actually, so you can see all the videos with unique question and answers. If you're new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now let's get started. Can we add AD groups in Power BI report or dashboard in email subscription? So we have an option, email subscription in Power BI service. There can we add the AD groups or just we can add a single email ID? The answer is yes, we can, but the workspace has to be in Power BI premium capacity or it has to be a Power BI premium per user. And the main thing is we need to enable some settings in the tenant settings, that is the email subscription option in tenant settings. And the next thing is, can we change the DAX calculated column value dynamically as per the user selection in Power BI? This mostly people are aware of it. The answer is no, we cannot, because the calculated columns are computed during the database table processing or refreshing time and then stored into the model. So once this is stored in the model, we cannot able to change the value of it. But it is possible in the measures, as measures calculated on the fly during the user interaction with any visual. The next thing is, while adding a DAX calculated column, why other table columns are not listed down in Power BI? Even though this looks a simple question, but it has an depth knowledge of it. The reason is calculated columns are tied up with the base table. We cannot move it to a different table, right? But the measures we can move to different tables, but for calculated column, we cannot move it. So we can bring other table columns. For that, we need to use some DAX functions like related table, related, or lookup value function. And the next is difference between explicit and implicit measures in Power BI. So here's the difference in the table. So implicit measures is created automatically by the pivot table, pivot chart, or visuals in Power BI. Pivot table is nothing but the matrix table. Whereas explicit measures creates manually by user. We create the functions like sum, sumx, max, min. And implicit is not visible on the fields pane on the right side, but the explicit measures is visible on the fields pane because we are creating those measures, so we can able to see those values, those names. And implicit, we can rename the title. Once we drag and drop into the visuals, we can rename it. But explicit also we can rename it, as we are manually doing it, so we can rename it. For implicit, it is not reusable. It is only specific to that visual where we have used that. But for explicit, we can reuse to multiple cases like tables, visuals, or APIs, or cards, anywhere else. The next thing is, can a contributor update an app in Power BI service? Yes, a setting needs to be enabled for that workspace. This is recently they have added, I think 3 or 4 months back, that the step is they had to go to the settings of that workspace and then scroll down to the security settings at the last and tick the checkbox allow contributor to update the app for this workspace. This is how it will look like. This is the settings of the workspace, and at the bottom of that for now is security settings allow contributors to update the app for this workspace. To enable this and save, and by default contributors don't have permission to update an app, but by enabling these options they can able to update the app. Please share this interview question and answer with others, as most of the people have to be aware of those questions and they have to be successful in their career. Thanks for watching, keep learning and keep sharing.